at home in the presence of Jesus. Hearing him call me his own, just feeling at home, feeling at home. Putting my feet right under his table, knowing I won't be alone, just feeling at home.
When it comes to Mother's Day, thoughts naturally turn to home and family and the significance and security of having a home. There are little rituals and characteristics that are part of me at home that I wouldn't exhibit if I were visiting your home. Why? Quite simply because I am at home. I am in a place where I can be quite relaxed. And what sort of things do I do at home to make me feel comfortable? Put on old clothes, kick off my shoes, relax, become more myself. What is quite obvious is that home is a place where, quite simply, I feel at home. What is true of an earthly home is also true of our heavenly home.
You are no longer foreigners and strangers, but fellow citizens with God's people and also members of his household, built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets, with Christ Jesus himself as the chief cornerstone. In him, the whole building is joined together and rises to become a holy temple in the Lord. And in him, you too are being built together to become a dwelling in which God lives by his Spirit.
A house and a home are very different. A house is just a physical structure made perhaps of brick or wood or stone. It can be large or small. It may not have people inside. If a house does not include people, the house is not really a home. It is what transpires inside the house that makes it a home. Danny had spent most of his formative years living with his mum in a caravan on a vacant block just outside of town. His father had abandoned the family and his mum had done her best to raise her son. One day, someone asked Danny, "Don't you wish you had a real home?" Danny's reply was wise beyond his years. He said, "We have a real home. We just don't have a house to put it in." How many times have you said, "I want to go home"? Now, obviously, you are not talking about some building or man-made structure. Rather, you are talking about what the place means to you and what takes place there. If I asked you to show me your home, you would probably take me and show me the place where you live. But that's not really home, in the fullest sense of the word. Home is really something that is perhaps intangible and abstract. Yet it is still something that is very real. Home is a place where it is comfortable, pleasant and safe. Home has a certain feeling of security about it, a sanctuary in what at times is an overwhelming world. In the same way, we ought to feel at home in the presence of God. We are not strangers, but members of God's own household. Well aware that there are some for whom home has not been a happy experience, and there remains painful images and memories. Some are now sole occupants in a house, and perhaps it is at times lonely, but it is still home. The sort of home I am talking about is a positive and happy experience. No longer do I call you servants, said Jesus. For the servant does not know what his master is doing, but I have called you friends. And when I talk about being at home with God, in a spiritual family, I am not referring to what will happen in eternity. What we are thinking about today is in the present, the here and now. Home is a place that gives me a location. I know where I belong. I have no need to feel a stranger or an outsider. I know where it is that my spirit belongs. One of the most comforting things in this temporal life is to know that we have a place where we can belong, knowing where home is.
Under his wings I'm safely abiding, though the night deepens and tempests are wild. Still I can trust in my Lord, he will keep me. He has redeemed me.
In the earlier days of the Salvation Army, it was normal to refer to others in the fellowship as brother and sister. So I would have been addressed as Brother Woodbury and my wife as Sister Woodbury. Perhaps quaint in this day and age. It may well be that by relegating such terminology to yesteryear, we have lost an essential component from within the Christian fellowship. The security and solidarity of this family is in Jesus himself. He is the one who holds it together. For God has already placed Jesus Christ as the one and only foundation, and no other foundation can be laid. Families and home are places where children learn and grow. Most parents are anxious that their children should learn and become mature. In the family of God, it is Jesus who stimulates growth. Growth in us personally, and numerical growth in this family. We are among God's closest relatives we are his family. We are told that we will be called the sons of the living God.
But when the set time had fully come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those under the law, that we might receive adoption to sonship. Because you are his sons, God sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, the Spirit who calls out, Abba, Father.
You'll notice we say brother and sister around here. You know why? It's because we're a family and these folks are so dear. When one has a heartache, we all share the tears and rejoice in each victory. In this family so dear, I'm so glad I'm a part of the family of God. I've been washed in the fountain, cleansed by his blood, joint heirs with Jesus as we travel the sun. For I'm part of the family of God. From the door of an orphanage to the house of the king, no longer an outcast, a new song I sing. From rags unto riches, from the weak to the strong, I'm not worthy to be here, but praise God I belong. Oh, sing the song!
I'm so glad I'm a part of the family of God.
I've been washed in the fountain, cleansed by his blood, joiners with Jesus as we travel this side. For I'm part of the family of God. Yes, I'm part of the family. The family of God.
The secret of the church is that Christ lives within it. The message of the church is to declare the living Christ and his central theme of reconciliation. Reconciliation is the key word and the hinge pin in having real familyship in God's family. There are family responsibilities. Just to belong to the family of God is not enough. To become a new creation is not enough. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away and the new has come. All this is from God, who through Christ Jesus reconciled us to himself and gave us, that's you and me, the ministry of reconciliation. That is, in Christ God was reconciling the world to himself. Or, as the Good News Bible puts it, God gave us the task of making others his friends also. No part of this family is excess baggage. All are equally important, and in the same way, no member of the family is just along for the ride. Men may put up their barriers. Churches may keep their communion tables for their own members. God never does. It is the tragedy of the church that it is often more exclusive than God. Each has a right to be part of that family, and each has a right to share in the joy, the burdens, and the responsibilities of that family. With family privileges come family responsibilities. This family to which I belong is infused and saturated with the presence of the Spirit of God. It has, as it were, a family spirit, the Holy Spirit. It provides a home where the Spirit of Christ can dwell and minister, and where all who love Christ can meet in that spirit. You two are being built together with all the others into a place where God lives through His Spirit. It is God's purpose and design that you should be a vessel through which His Holy Spirit can minister and work in the world today. It is God's deepest desire that all might belong to His family, not just in eternity, but also in the here and now. I believe in transformation. God can change the hearts of men and refine the evil nature till it glows with grace again. Others may reject the weakling. I believe he can be strong. To the family of Jesus, all God's children may belong. I invite you to join with me in prayer. Father, we have been reminded today of the richness and security of the Christian family of God. Help us, Father, to treasure and cherish the security and sanctuary of that relationship which binds us all together, regardless of background and circumstances. Remind us, Father, that we are no longer strangers, but children in the household of God, secure in a perfect love that is absolute and unchangeable, and that nothing, but nothing, can ever separate us from that love. Father, give us the sensitivity and compassion to not only know that there are those outside this family that need to be embraced, but also give us the courage to reach out to them in true Christian love and compassion. Hear our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.